Her debut album sold 3 million copies and went to number one in 5 countries. And to think Amy McDonald's ambition was to be a geography teacher. And you're singing the songs, thinking this is a life. And you wake up in the morning and your hip is twist the size. Where you gonna go? Where you gonna go? Or where you gonna sleep tonight?
And here she is. Welcome back.
She's looking gorgeous.
Hi, lovely to see you.
You too.
So this is the album is A Curious Thing, which is out today, which I have here in my hand. And the single which you're going to do for us is Don't Tell Me That It's Over, which actually is not a love song.
It isn't a love song, no. I think people hear the lyrics and automatically think I'm begging my boyfriend not to leave me. But it isn't. It's just a song about doing things for yourself and not feeling pressurised into doing something.
And well, did you see someone at an awards ceremony?
I did, but it didn't really fully inspire the song the way that it's been written down. Okay. I think that was to make it sound a bit more glamorous than it actually was.
Right.
But did you feel more pressure with this album? Because the first one, obviously, like we just said, it was number one in 5 countries, so it did really, really well. And obviously it's like that second album coming back again.
Yeah, I feel pressure now because it's been released and it's waiting to hear that the fans like it. So now I'm feeling the most pressure. I didn't feel bad when I was writing it. The songs came quite easily, which was unexpected. But I do feel very nervous now.
Proud of it?
Very proud, very happy with how everything sounds, and I just hope everyone likes it as much as I do.
And you're out on the road quite soon as well, aren't you? Again?
Yeah, I've got a UK tour which starts at the end of March.
And your bloke what's he called? What's the name
He's
of your
called
chap?
Stevie Lovell.
Stephen, there he is, yes. Plays for Partick Thistle.
He does, yes.
And is it true that when you were out on the road the last time, when you came back, he decorated the whole house?
Oh. He had, and he'd built me a walk-in wardrobe, which was the nicest thing that I think any man has ever done.
That's amazing.
Yeah, hung up all my clothes and everything.
That's like the Sex and the City movie.
Exactly. He was like Mr. Big.
So this is why you're going out on the road. If you've got stuff that you need doing around the house.
Yeah, I come home, everything's clean, it's all tidy.
Thank you for coming back today.
Thank you
very much indeed, guys. That's it for today.